Senator Gary Peters is leading a pack of Democrats who believe Michael Avenatti ruined the case against Brett Kavanaugh, being removed from his nomination for United States Supreme Court Justice. The Michigan Democrat told CNN that the lawyer, who represented Stormy Daniels in her case against President Donald Trump, and announced he was considering a career in politics as a Democratic presidential candidate amid the SCOTUS sexual assault allegations, turned the story into a spectacle. "It turns it into a circus atmosphere, and certainly that's not where we should be," he said about the allegations raised by Avenatti and his client Julie Swetnick, adding, "At some point there were a lot of folks coming forward making all sorts of accusations." He continued, "I think we should have focused on the serious allegations, that certainly appeared very credible to me, that would be our best course of action." Swetnick claimed she had seen Kavanaugh fondling and grabbing girls without their consent at numerous parties between 1981 and 1983. She alleged he was part of a group that spiked drinks and lined up to gang rape young women who did not have control of their actions. The accuser added that his friend Mark Judge was also there, but didn't say they were one of the people who assaulted the victims, nor did she provide names of witnesses. For many, it meant she wasn't credible after Dr. Christine Blasey Ford's sexual assault claim and second accuser Deborah Ramirez's sexual misconduct allegation. While Avenatti told his client's story to the media, he also shared his political ambitions, which didn't bode well with Democrats who believe his involvement set us back, absolutely. Democrats in the country would have been better off if Mr. Avenatti spent his time on his Iowa vanity project rather than meddling in Supreme Court fights, an anonymous senior Senate Democratic aide said. Another Democrat on the Senate Judiciary Committee, who wished not to be named, said, "It wasn't helpful because the story became about Avenatti." Ranking Democrat on the Senate Judiciary Committee, Dianne Feinstein, called for the confirmation to be paused after the third allegation emerged, but at that point many Democrats believed the story was getting less credible and distanced themselves from Avenatti's client's allegations. But it was too late. Republican Susan Collins mentioned the evidence against him not being reliable enough as she voted to confirm him and was met with protests afterwards. CNN also obtained a comment from an unnamed Democratic senator who said he was not helpful at all. "I think Susan was always yes, but Avenatti was a useful foil." Avenatti said his client was willing to testify under oath, but she was not approached by the FBI in their probe into Kavanaugh's past. Senator Ed Markey called the investigation a White House-directed cover-up, and the Democrat from Massachusetts refused to give more attention to Swetnick and Avenatti when he thought there was a bigger problem. He said, "I just consider this to be a larger story." Peters didn't think any distractions from Dr. Ford's case helped. "So there are always efforts, whenever you're dealing with a serious issue like this, that people want to change the discussion and have everybody chance another different shiny object," Peters continued. "Our job in the Senate, and it should have been the job of the FBI too, is to focus on those that are credible." In a response, Avenatti called the Democrats cowards who were blaming accusers for coming forward. He also told CNN that Collins' labeling of his client's claims as outlandish was unfair because they did not investigate Swetnick, who he says has six supporting witnesses. Avenatti reaffirmed the idea of running for POTUS 2020. He said, "Many establishment Democrats are concerned because they see me as a threat